I'm so happy to see you. I think I have my mic on this time. Let's check if I plugged it in. Yes, I plugged it in. Okay, let's start. Today I want to share with you that I still have a giveaway running, a contest running. So if you want to enter the draw, you can win 1 month of clicker training with me. So that's 4 hours coaching. So I'm already looking forward to meet the winner and help the person for 4 weeks for free. And I chose to do it for 4 weeks because then I can really get somebody just on their journey and help them a lot. Today's topic is what do you do when your horse says no in training? Because clicker training is all about giving the horse a choice. And if you give him a choice and ask him, do you want to do this? He can say yes and do it, or he can say, I'm not sure, or no, or absolutely not, and he won't do it. So, hi Donna, nice to see you. So what do you do if your horse says no in clicker training? Well, first of all, you assess the situation. Is he not doing it because what's the reason? Is he afraid? So he doesn't want to do it because he wants to avoid whatever you were asking. Or maybe something else is way more interesting than what you are asking, and his all attention is maybe outside the arena, and he's just seeing and looking at what his friends are doing, or he doesn't understand the situation. So depending on why the horse doesn't cooperate, you adjust your training. But that's the start. Always ask yourself, why is he not doing this? Maybe my reinforcer is not reinforcing anymore, because the values of your reinforcers can go up and down. If you give your horse like 10 carrots, the 11th carrot, he's like, no, I'm not interested anymore. But a horse can also get bored because you are not raising your criteria, or you raise them too high and then he doesn't understand the assignment anymore. And sometimes, especially in the beginning, it can be hard to raise your criteria, because when are you raising them and when not? So if your horse says no in training, first you have to figure out why you think he says no, and then adjust your training. Hi Donna, nice to see you. I have an example, and somebody else told me about that the same week, this week or a few weeks ago. The problem was that if you work at liberty and your horse wanders off to just eat all the greens that are growing outside the arena, or maybe even in the arena, what do you do? Because it can be very frustrated, because you are here with a pocket full of treats and your horse wanders off, because that doesn't feel good. But don't take it personally. It's not because of you, but it's because something else is more reinforcing at that moment for your horse. So it's just information. And when Kira wandered off to eat the greens outside the arena, that was such a logical thing for her to do. It's information for me. Oh, she wants to eat. But she apparently chooses the food that is free accessible at that point over the treats that I have in my pocket. So how can I change that? I can change that by lowering my criteria or making the challenges a little bit more interesting for her. So don't be boring, basically. Just change the behaviors you ask. And what I did is I practiced with the target stick to ask Kira to come away from the greens, and I clicked her for turning away from the lush bushes that were growing outside the arena. And every time she decided the target stick over the food that is free accessible, I clicked and reinforced her. And I also changed my treats. I changed them to my homemade horse treats with cinnamon, and I know she loves them. And I haven't used them in a while, so they were again relatively new and exciting for her. So that really helped. And I also adjusted my training time. I made my training sessions a little bit shorter. So Donna says, I've had many moments like this. I just let it go. Well, you don't have to let it go. Well, the thing is, sometimes your ego comes in play. At least that was what happened with me. Like, I'm a horse trainer, and now my horse walks away from me, and that's pretty frustrated. But that part I let go, and then I could see, okay, she's walking away from me and she's walking towards something else. So what's going on? Is it a moving away motivation, or is it moving towards motivation? And it was obvious that the greenery outside the arena had such a pull on her, which was very understandable because she's on a diet, because she's prone to laminitis. So she's gaining weight super easily. So yeah, she's on a restricted diet. So of course she wants to eat the greens. So that was really, that was not hard for me to understand. So that's how I changed the situation. Hi, Mark, nice to see you. I'm talking about what you can do if your horse says no in training. So I already gave some solutions. You can change your criteria. You can adjust your criteria. You can change your treats, your reinforcers. Try to find a little bit higher reinforcers. Or you can also change the rate of reinforcing, the ROR, the rate of reinforcing. And that means that you just click a little bit sooner and feed quicker, and then you go, 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 and you just don't give your horse really a chance to wander off, because there's something happening and clicks are coming and clicks are coming and clicks are coming. So you do like a really quick session, like and keep your horse engaged. So there is some really high value, which is can top whatever else is going on in the environment of the horse that might be distracting. If it's fear and your horse chooses not to do whatever you're asking because he's fear, then you're probably lumping, and then you have to split the criteria, split the behavior and make the increments a little bit smaller so your horse can just adjust mentally and get over his fear. So those were my tips for today. If your horse, what you can do if your horse says no in training. So the best tip is not to take it personally, and to see what's going on. And if you don't know, guess why the horse is walking away. You probably can guess pretty right. And then you try it out. And if it still doesn't work, you just guess again. What else can I do? And ask help. Always ask help. Those were my tips. If you want to have some private coaching, I will give away a month of free coaching sessions, 1 hour each week for 1 month, to really help you accelerate and improve your training tremendously. So if you want, you can find the link in the description of the video, and I would love to hear from you. Bye for now. Cheers. Happy horse training.